Greetings and welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at material instancing, which is a very powerful and useful feature when working with materials in Unreal Engine 4. But first, what is material instancing?
Instancing
is where you take a single parent material, like so. We'll make a little block that represents a parent material. And you make copies of it that have variations. So here is the copy, which would actually be referred to as a child, or an instance. You can really call it either one. And here's another one. So here's another child. Now, why is this useful? Well, it's useful for a lot of reasons. For instance, let's say your parent material is like the perfect basic metal. Well, your children that you create from that will start off with all of the features that made this a perfect metal. And then you can accentuate that and turn them into specific variations, such as copper or aluminum or aluminium if you're from that part of the world. So what you're doing essentially is starting off with the exact same properties and you're making changes to them. And these properties are going to be referred to as parameters. And a parameter is just a value that can change once you instance off a material. So let's go ahead and take a look here inside of Unreal. Now, I will admit I was going to make an instance out of this material that we were creating in the previous videos, but it's complex enough that I feel like I would just scare people, so we won't actually do that. We're going to make something much simpler. So for starters, let's begin here in the content browser, and notice I'm in the materials folder. Just right-click and create a new material, which I'm simply going to call parent. Now, of course, on your end, you might want to call yours something a bit more descriptive, maybe put your name on it, but we'll just call it parent. And let's start off by defining that. And this is always the first thing you're going to do, is create a parent material just like any other regular material. However, what makes this different from the materials we've made up to now is that we're going to use parameters instead of regular constant values. For example, one of the first things I showed you how to do when creating a material is to create a 3 vector, which I just held down the 3 key and clicked. We can double click on its text, on its color swatch, and assign any color we like and plug that into base color. And that's fine. This would work. The problem, though, is that this is a constant value and can never change. Once this material is compiled, that's it. Actually, a quick note about that as well. And so if I jump back to my chalkboard, one of the more important things about instancing is that when it comes to compiling, only your parent material is actually compiled. The children essentially are free. They don't actually cost anything in terms of compiling. So it does speed things up a bit in terms of performance. So let's jump back over here to Unreal. Thank you. And we're not going to use a constant value this time. Instead, we're going to create a vector parameter. Now, the first thing you'll notice when you create a vector parameter is that it wants you to give it a name, which is exactly what we're going to do. We're going to call this base color, and we will plug that right into base color. And let's give it a default value. And let's say we'll just make this white, or actually kind of a very, very pale gray for starters, which looks very, it essentially looks white when you look at it. So the difference between these two nodes is that when we instance this off, we will have access to this node and we can make changes. Now, I want to get just a little bit fancy straight out of the gate because I think it'll help you understand more of how things work in terms of material instancing. So we're going to bring in a texture. So let me go back over here to my content browser and click on the textures folder. And let's just pick on let's grab something that is kind of metal-like. So we have T, base metal D, and base metal N. Let's grab both of these, so both of the base metal textures, And I can select them by both by holding down Control and clicking on the second one, and I can drag them together into my material, and you'll see they both appear. Now, this is how I was adding textures before. And technically this works, but the problem is that these are not parameters. These would be constant, and they would always remain the same for our object. Not entirely useful. So I'm going to delete those real quick. I just wanted to show you that there is a difference to adding those in. Let me grab base metal D, and with that selected in the content browser, here in the material editor, I will right click, and let's just type in parameter. And here's our list of parameters. You'll see texture sample parameter 2D. So click on that. And this is asking for a name. You'll see the base name it gives is actually really long and not particularly useful. So let's call this base color texture. Now, because we're calling this base color texture, I would like to rename this node from base color to actually, and I can do this in the details panel by clicking on the parameter name property, we're going to call this base color tint. So we have tint and we have texture. And all we're going to do is multiply the two together. So let's drag a wire off of base color tint and type multiply and press enter. And then we'll drag a wire off of base color texture, like so, and we'll plug that into base color. So already we have a much more interesting material than we had a moment ago. Okay, so now we want the ability to control metallic as well. So let's drag a wire off of metallic, and this time I'll just type scalar parameter, or just scalar, and you can press enter. And we will call this metallic, like so. But just to show you it's different, okay, normally I would call it metallic, okay, just to point this out, but I'm going to call it metallic. I'm just going to put my initial at the end of it, just to show you that it's different than the actual metallic value of the zero. We'll call it metallic Z, which is probably a really terrible cover band. Okay, so now, and if that really is a cover band, I'm just kidding. I've never heard of that cover band, just to make sure everybody understands that. So now let's also use roughness as well. So I'll drag a wire off and make another scalar parameter, which I'll call, let's call this my roughness. So we know it's my value, it's a custom value. Okay, we don't use my, we use custom roughness. Custom roughness. That's better. See, that's cleaner. That makes more sense. So let's use custom roughness, or custom metallic as well. Okay, so that's all much more concise. Now we need to bring in our normal map. So here in the content browser, I'm gonna click, right click over here, and another parameter, we want a texture sample parameter 2D, and we'll call this normal texture, and we will simply plug this into the normal map. So we have all of these parameters plugged into our surface, so that's working well. Let's see, is there anything else I want to do? I think for starters, just for kind of getting people warmed up, this is probably enough. So let's go ahead and click apply and make sure we save this, and then we can close out the material editor entirely. Let's go back to our materials folder, and at the very bottom we'll see parent, and I'm not going to apply parent to the surface. Instead, I'm going to right click on parent and choose create material instance. And the instance was created, it's down here at the bottom. Let's go ahead, and you'll notice it's called parent underscore instance. Let's right click and rename that. And we'll just call this instance. Actually, let's do it instance underscore one for our purposes. And because of alphabetical order, that'll appear up at the very top. Let's select this object here in our view, and I'll drag this onto element zero to apply this to our surface. And here's what we get by default. Now, if I double click on the actual material instance, and before I do, let me point something out. Notice the thumbnails here between a regular material and a material instance. You'll see that the material instance has a slightly darker green border, just something to point out. If I double click on this material instance, I get the material instance editor. this is a bit different than the actual material editor. You have a toolbar, you have a details panel, you have some instance parents to show you who your parent material is, and then you have just a great big preview. Also, the important thing to show off here is that here in your parameter groups, you'll see all of those parameters you created. So here are our texture parameter values, here are our scalar parameter values, or our single numbers, and then our vector parameter values. Now, let's go ahead and make a few edits. I'll leave this nice and big for now. Let's start off by saying we want to change the base color tint. All we need to do is check this checkbox next to the property, and this basically says we'd like to override this with our own color. Then I'll click, and let's just start sliding around and choosing a different color. And we get instantaneous feedback. And I'll go ahead and pull alpha up. It won't make any change as far as we're concerned. I just feel better about it being up. And you can see, again, nice, super fast feedback. We can click OK, but more importantly, if I take my material instance editor and slide it off here to the side, watch this. As I change values, watch in the viewport. We get instant feedback out here as well. Now this is a very handy way to work. So handy, in fact, that one of the things that our artists will do is quickly put together their materials with some parameters in place, and then make an instance of that material and use the instance to tweak values in a scene so that you can get something perfected very quickly with this nice real-time feedback. So we'll choose this kind of pale shade of blue, and then we'll come over to our scalar parameters, and let me slide this bar over. Let's take custom metallic, and we can slide this up toward 1, and you can see the surface now looks very metallic. And we can take our custom roughness value and we can tweak that as well. And now we start to get a very metal-like surface. Let's go ahead and set metallic all the way up to 1 so it's a true metal. Now we can also replace textures as well. So if I go down to the textures panel, let's say we want to turn this into a brick surface. Again, you'll notice I made those texture parameter values. We can check base color texture and normal texture, and checking those boxes just means that we want to be able to override what's already there. So let's take our bricks diffuse or bricks D and we'll drag that to the color, and then we'll take our bricks normal and drag that on top of the normal map, and we're already done. Now we have brick. Probably makes more sense now for us to change the color. And now the nice thing here is that we can start making multiple copies of this material. So let's go back to materials. And let's just come up here to our instance. I'll right click on it and choose create copy. And we'll call this instance 2. And here in the viewport, I don't want to necessarily roll back. Let's just hold down Alt and right click, drag and push back just a little bit. I'll slide this over to the side, and let's hold down Alt and drag out a second copy. And with the second copy selected, let me get the Material Instance Editor out of the way. I will apply Instance 2 to Element 0. And then I just want to show this to you. If I double click on Instance 2, notice we have two panels now. Here's Instance 1 and Instance 2, and they can both be entirely different things. So again, I'm using my screen space as best I can. This is one more reason why it's a nice idea to have two monitors if you can manage. So let's take instance 2, and we'll expand its texture parameters, and let's just get some different textures. So instead of brick, let's say we want this one to actually look like, here's copper. So let's use copper for the main texture. Let's use the metal normal, and then let's not override base color, and suddenly this looks just like copper. Let's go back to instance 1, and let's take the base color tint, and we're gonna pull the actual color value down really low, so it's just using a little bit of that color, and then we'll take the metallic value, and we won't override that anymore, so that's just a non-metal. And let's take our custom roughness, and we'll kick that up pretty high, say up to about 8. And now, as you can see, we have two very different materials, but they both come from the same parent, meaning that only that parent material would actually be compiled if this were a game, and both of these two very different materials would essentially be free. Now, there's only one more thing I want to show off, and that is that right now, you'll notice that our parameter groups are just called texture parameter values and scalar parameter values, and they're not particularly useful. So the last thing I'd like to do is jump into my materials folder, and let's open up our parent one more time, and I want to show you on each one of these parameters, you'll notice you have a group that you can edit as well. So let's take our base color tint, and I'm going to set its group value. We'll actually type a value in here. We're going to call this color adjustment. Then for custom metallic, let's call this surface definition. Actually, I like, just to drive home, this is a physically based system. Let's call this physical surface. So it's where we define the physical surface. Then I can click on roughness, and you'll notice this is also a dropdown. So any groups that I've already typed in here, I can just reassign very quickly. So let's set this to physical surface. And we'll take the normal texture and the base color texture, and let's just call this texture overrides. And we'll assign this to texture overrides as well. So now if I hit apply, let's make sure to save. If I go back into the instance editors, take a look at my new parameter groups. We have color adjustment, which has my color tint. We have physical surface, which has metallic and roughness. And we have texture overrides, where you can see my base color texture and my normal texture. So it's a really nice way to keep things organized. So that's a look at creating material instances and controlling them in UE4. That's going to wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.